ഹലോ ഫ്രണ്ട്സ്, വീണ്ടും ഒരു കോവിഡ് ഡേയിലാണ് നമ്മളുള്ളത്. ഈ ആഴ്ച നമ്മുടെ ഗസ്റ്റ് ഐറ്റം ബോസ് അറ്റ് ഹോമിൽ വരുന്നത് ഇന്ത്യയിലെ ഏറ്റവും വലിയ ഡിസൈനറായിട്ടുള്ള ഓട്ടോമൊബൈൽ ഡിസൈനറായിട്ടുള്ള ദിലീപ് ചാബ്രയാണ്. ഡി സി എന്നുള്ള ഷോർട്ട് നെയിമിൽ അറിയപ്പെടുന്ന ദിലീപ് ചാബ്രയുമായിട്ടുള്ള ഒരു ഇന്ററാക്ഷനാണ് ഇന്നത്തെ എപ്പിസോഡിൽ ആദ്യമായിട്ട്. വെൽക്കം ടു ഓട്ടോഗ്രാഫ്. എന്ന് പറയുമ്പോൾ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് എല്ലാവർക്കും അറിയാവുന്ന ഒരു പേര് തന്നെയാണ്. ഇന്ത്യയിൽ ആദ്യമായിട്ട് ഒരു ഓട്ടോമോട്ടീവ് സ്റ്റൈലിഷ് ഡിസൈനറായിട്ട് വന്നിരുന്ന വ്യക്തിയാണ് ദിലീപ് ചാബ്രയ. ദിലീപ് ചാബ്രയുടെ ആദ്യമുള്ള മോഡിഫിക്കേഷൻസ് എല്ലാം തന്നെ നമ്മുടെ റോഡിലെ കാറുകളെ ഭംഗി കൂട്ടുന്ന രീതിയിലായിരുന്നു വന്നത്. പിന്നീട് അദ്ദേഹം പല തരത്തിലുള്ള കാറുകളും അതുപോലെ തന്നെ കാരവാൻസും മറ്റുള്ള വെഹിക്കിൾസും എല്ലാം ഡെവലപ്പ് ചെയ്തു. അദ്ദേഹം സ്വന്തമായിട്ട് കാറും ഡെവലപ്പ് ചെയ്തു, ഡി സി അവാന്തി എന്ന് പറയുന്ന സ്പോർട്സ് കാർ. ഇത്രയും ഒരു വലിയൊരു ബാനറുള്ള ഒരു വ്യക്തിയാണ് ഇന്ന് നമുക്ക് സ്പെഷ്യൽ ഗസ്റ്റ് ആയിട്ട് വരുന്നത്. Hello sir, welcome to the show. Today one of the most talked topic in auto industry, especially in India, is the ambassador, which you have recently showcased as a design form. My audience and me are very keen to know about that. Can you please explain what is your plan with that concept?
Thank you, Team Autograph. You know, the e-ambassador that we unveiled a couple of days back was a continuation of our pursuit of manufacturing limited and niche lifestyle cars. And in that context, we were looking for a product that would be quite distinct from the other manufacturers' offerings. In continuation of that product, we thought of an ambassador. Of course, it's an electric ambassador. It's very powerful, 160 kW. It was prompted by the huge response that we got for the AmbiRod, which we showcased at the 2008 Delhi Auto Expo. And till this day, we get enough inquiries evincing interest in such a car. So we took those cues, and we said, what can we do to produce a car that will fit in the modern times, be a harbinger of things to come in the automotive world, and therefore obviously it boiled down to being an e-ambassador in that sense. So, you know, as you can see from the visuals, the e-ambassador retains the DNA of the ambassador, but of course it's 40-50 years ahead from the 50s ambassador that got introduced in India. We also felt that this is a car that will distinctly stand out from the other cars, which, you know, all are cookie cutter cars. They are commodities in that sense. The layman really can't differentiate a brand from the other, and this is very, very distinctive. It's very, very iconic in that sense. And also we felt that the elite in India would love to drive such a car or be driven in such a car, because it stands for uniquely Indian and not a product that is crafted from across the world to India. So that was the ethos of the e-ambassador.
Thank you, sir. Avanti, one of the first Indian indigenously developed sports car, had a very warm red carpet welcome to the India. How does it do now? Can we expect such new models from DC House anytime soon?
The Avanti was born out of a niche that we wanted to exploit in the Indian marketplace. You know, all men, when they're young, they aspire to have a sports car, but they can never afford one. In fact, I used to, you know, stand by a showroom of the State Trading Corporation, which used to auction cars that were, left behind by the diplomats. And every time I bid for it, it went way above the reserve price, and therefore I couldn't afford one. So, you know, it's well known across the world that, when you want a sports car, you can never afford one. And therefore, if you see currently the profile of customers across the world who buy sports cars are older men who never are able to really enjoy the performance of the cars per se, but they always have that wish or dream to have owned one. And that's how the Avanti was created. It was a dream that I had since the last 10 years, and I'm happy to say that I actually achieved my dream. Following the Avanti, of course, you have the another supercar, that's the TCA, which was exhibited at the 2018 Auto Expo Delhi. Again, that's an electric car. The electrification of cars, whether it's the e-Ambassador or the TCA, makes eminent sense in India today, because the taxation part the Avanti has a handicap of 53% GST, including the cess, and an electric Avanti would have only 5% GST. Though the electrification costs are higher than the gasoline engine car, yet because of the taxation, it may turn out to be a little cheaper. And what you have is a car that will probably do 0 to 100 in 5 seconds or 4 seconds thereabouts.
Sir, you have always amazed and surprised us with some of the exotic designs and products you've brought in. We have seen such products in some of the Bollywood movies, and even one car has been the hero of one movie, the Tarzan. Can you please share some of your experience and story behind Tarzan?
We've had a reasonable presence in Indian films. I don't like to use the word Bollywood because it's a pejorative term, but we've had a good presence in Dil To Pagal Hai, Yash Chopra movie, where Shah Rukh Khan drives it. Then of course in Chal Mere Bhai, where Salman Khan drives. And then Love Ke Liye Kuch Bhi Karega, which was a Saif Ali Khan vehicle. And then of course Tarzan the Wonder Car, which you have talked about and you want to know. The essence of a Hindi film is that it has to succeed at the box office, and it can only succeed at the box office if it has a repeat value. So when the producers and the directors, that is Abbas Mastan and Mr. Gordon Thanwani, they came to me with a script, and they really, what they required was a car that was in that sense a car into the throwback era. And I felt that they needed to really revisit that strategy, because if the goal was to make a car so desirable that people would go again and again to see the movies, it had to be a car that was futuristic, it had to be a car which they had never seen before, it had to be an absolute eye candy and drop dead gorgeous. And having said that, they agreed with me unanimously, and we went about doing a car that was unlike any other car. Even if you see the car today on the screen, that car was delivered to them in 2003, and it's 17 years now on, and you really can't say that it's dated at all. Of course, the expectedly as envisaged, the car got a fantastic response. In fact, the movie's success rests on the car, and that was expected to be, and I realized that it would be a great leverage for us from a visibility point of view, from the reach point of view, because Bollywood has a huge reach. And that's what actually happened, and you'll be amazed to know that it is the single most highest grossing movie on television for the last a decade and a half, much higher grossing than other mainstream movies that you could probably think of, like Three Idiots and the other ilk. So, you know, what made the car so unique was, of course, obviously it was low, fast, wide, long. Typical supercar proportions. It had a mid-engine, it had a Toyota mid-engine. But because it was a movie, it had to have something that was, you know, sci-fi in that sense. So there are two halves of the car. So the rear half, which has the power plant, and the front half, which really is a cockpit in that sense. And they're connected through four connectors. That was the essence of the design and the styling, and that's what I just commented a few minutes back, that even today when I see the car on screen, I think it really stands out, and it belies the age of 17 years or 18 years that we delivered the car. And you know, most designers, actually, once they design a car, they don't want to see it. They feel they could have done better. That's a phobia that we all have, and even I have. But this is a car, this is one of the few cars that when I see on the screen, I'm very proud of what I've done.
Cars, caravans, private jet, all comes under your portfolio. But which one is the last one rolled out from your design house before the lockdown?
We're very proud of the fact that we have automotive and non-automotive customers. So on the one hand, you have the automotive OEMs, like a BMW, Rolls-Royce, you know, General Motors, Aston Martin, and you have private individuals like Shah Rukh Khan, Amitabh Bachchan, and several elites, industrial and political. So we can't talk of all the projects because when you're doing some projects for the global elite and you know, automotive OEMs, you are governed by strict NDA norms, and therefore we can't talk. But you know, to your question, which is a car that we delivered just prior to the lockdown, was the Mercedes V-Class to Hrithik Roshan and a Toyota Crysta to Madhuri Dixit. I think we delivered about a day or 2 days before the lockdown.
Now we are in the COVID situation, and post-COVID, how do you think the Indian automobile industry would like, especially when it compared to the global market?
It is my belief that the Indian auto industry will go through the same trajectory as the Chinese market went through. You know, in 2001, we were about 20,000 numbers removed from China. So they were at 650,000, we were in 630,000. 20 years down the line, they are at 24 million and we are at 3 million. And that the reason is simple, because China attracted a huge FDI investment consistently and large. Over the last 20 years, grew the consumerism in their society. So the eastern part of China, Shanghai, Beijing and the other areas, there were a lot of consumerism and you know, aspirations that grew and that actually fueled the car you know, sales. I think that was about to happen to India, because with this government, a stable government is seen in the world as strong, stable, having decisive you know, actions, will invite, I mean, we have already started getting good amount of foreign direct investment. This will continue consistently. It will create a lot of demand, of course, notwithstanding the current situation. In fact, the situation of lower demand has been persistent since the last year. And there were many reasons for that. Is because of the liquidity crisis, you know, prompted by the tight policy of Reserve Bank due to bank failures of the earlier regime.
Being the most senior auto designer, what could be some of your advice or tips for the aspiring and budding up auto designers in India?
So, having said that, obviously, there are, at any given point of time, there are 5,000 different cars and five different shapes of cars and SUVs in the world at any point of time. And each one of them have to be replaced every 5 years at least. So you can imagine the kind of demand for new designs is going to be there. and more so because the Indian market is very unique in the sense there will be demands on designers to cater to what the Indian market uniquely wants. And once the Indian market really grows in scale to a global level, I think we will start designing for the world as well. Unfortunately, there has been a dearth of design schools till late. Of course, I have one which has been operational for the last 10 years, but it takes about 20-25 years for designers to mature and come to a situation where they can contribute. But the future for car designers is huge, because remember one thing, anybody who is doing anything creative will always win in life, always, because it stands apart, something that is not going to be a commodity. And therefore, being in the car business, especially because it's a big ticket item, the development costs billions of dollars, a lot of responsibility rests on the designers. And therefore, if the car program's success or failure depends on car design per se, which you all probably know, that you know the leading cause of a car not doing well or doing well is design. And having said that, most managements will arm the car designers. So it's going to be a glorious future in the medium term. We have to forget the flip of the present. But I think in the medium term, if one is dedicated, one is passionate, I think it's going to be a great future for them.
Okay, sir. So let me come to some personal question. Which is your daily drive? And being a designer, which could be one of your favorite pick among the cars?
An Audi A8L. I commute between Bombay and Pune once a week. It's a very comfortable car to commute. Of course, in the family, we have the Maybachs and we have other cars as well. My favorite car has always been the Porsche 911, ever since it was introduced in the mid-60s. And they have so beautifully evolved over the years, every generation. I mean, it's such a gorgeous car. Of course, we have one in our family. My son has it in Delhi. It's quite impractical for me to use between Bombay and Pune. But that's a car that I really love. I've gone on record to say many times that's the most beautiful car ever designed, because remember, I attempted, you know, you probably are aware that we have done Aston Martins and Rolls Royces and Porsches and Mercedes. Every time I attempted to do a Porsche 911, I can only make it worse. I can never make it better. So design that it does not lend itself to any change is proof enough that it's a fantastically designed car.
Thank you so much, sir, for joining with us. It was great and pleasure to have you here in Autograph. So in the Autograph, we already different type of quarantine episode we enjoyed. നമ്മളെ ഇന്ത്യയിൽ തന്നെ ഏറ്റവും സ്പെഷ്യലായിട്ട് അല്ലെങ്കിൽ സോട്ട് ഔട്ട് ആയിട്ടുള്ള ഡിസൈനറായിരുന്നു നമ്മളെ കൂടെ ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നത്. അതുപോലെ തന്നെ ഇന്ത്യയിലെ ടോപ്പ് 12 മോഡൽസും നമുക്കുണ്ട്. ഇതിലെല്ലാം നിങ്ങളെ അഭിപ്രായ നിർദ്ദേശങ്ങളും നമ്മൾ അറിയിക്കണം. അതിനനുസരിച്ച് നമ്മൾ ഇതിൽ എപ്പിസോഡ് കൊണ്ടുവന്നായിരിക്കും. എന്തായാലും സ്റ്റേ ഹോം ആൻഡ് ബി സേഫ്.